Hello everyone, welcome back to our Resource Geography. Today we will be discussing about the nuclear power energy, which is commonly said that the energy that holds the key to the future. Nuclear power or the atomic power is obtained by altering the structure of the atoms. When such an alteration is made, much energy is released in the form of heat, and this is used to generate the electric power. For obtaining the atomic power, nuclear fission reaction is required, which takes place in a nuclear reactor containing a heat producing core and a cooling system. Within the core, the atoms of the fuel are being split. The heat released by the reactor is used to generate steam, and the steam is used to generate electricity. The first nuclear power station was built in Britain in 1956 at Calder Hall. In comparison to other traditional fossil fuels as energy sources, nuclear power produces an enormous amount of energy. The major sources of the nuclear power are uranium and thorium. The other minerals like plutonium, barium, zircon, and monazite are also considered as atomic minerals. Nuclear energy is one of the most controversial energy sources that we have. We talk always about the pros and the cons of this energy resource. For some people, the potential risk associated with nuclear power is too great. For others, the nuclear energy looks like the answer for a zero carbon future. While talking about the advantages, the nuclear energy is a very low cost energy. The construction of nuclear plants always have an high initial cost, but this type of energy is relatively cheap to produce as they have low operating cost. There are generally very less price fluctuation for the nuclear fuels when you compare with other traditional fossil fuels like coal and natural gas or petroleum, and hence the price of the nuclear energy can be predicted well into the future. Nuclear energy is one of the reliable sources of energy. The biggest benefit of the nuclear energy is that it can be generated at any time throughout the day, unlike the solar and the wind energy. The solar and the wind energy always depends upon the conditions of the weather. Thus, the nuclear energy is non-stop, as there will be no delay in the production of energy. Nuclear energy has a very huge advantage over the traditional source of energy like our fossil fuels, since it do not produce any carbon emission. Thus, nuclear energy can be also considered as a green energy that contributes to lower amount to the greenhouse gas emission in the atmosphere. According to the Nuclear Energy Institute, the nuclear electricity production almost prevents 528 million metric tons of carbon dioxide from being released into the atmosphere every year. The nuclear energy has a high energy density. In comparison to other fossil fuels, the nuclear power produces enormous amount of energy. No other source of energy can produce such amount of power from a very small quantity of material. It has been estimated that the amount of energy released in a nuclear fission reaction is 10 million times greater than the amount released when burning fossil fuels. Let's look into some of the cons of using the nuclear energy.
environmental impact. Although the nuclear power plants release zero carbon emission, it has substantial impact on the environment, mainly through the mining of the nuclear minerals and the water discharge. The uranium mining generally releases arsenic and radon, and this always have a negative impact on the health of the people or any living beings in and around the uranium mines. The nuclear power plants causes thermal pollution to condense the steam back into the water. We know that for the cooling system, water is highly essential, and most of the nuclear plants or reactors are situating near to the lake region or near to oceanic areas. When they release back this water to the lake or the oceans, it will alter the chemistry of the water bodies and thus making it inhabitable to most of the aquatic life. The risk of the nuclear accidents are generally very high. The nuclear power plants have a very strict safety measures in every place. However, a meltdown like what happened in the Fukushima and the Chernobyl or in the Three Mile Island in the Pennsylvania can have a catastrophic impact on the surrounding areas. Radioactive waste generated by the nuclear power plants. It is highly hazardous waste, and this waste created by the plants remains dangerously radioactive for thousands of years even after it is being created. If there comes any compromise or leakage in the storage facility, the radioactive mineral can cause considerable damage to the surrounding areas. We all know that nuclear minerals or the fuels used in the nuclear energy production are non-renewable sources. As they are finite resources and it takes millions of years back for its geological formation, the excessive mining of these nuclear fuels or minerals leads to the depletion of the resource. Now let's look into the global production and the distribution of nuclear energy in the world. Nuclear energy has now become an important source of energy in many countries of the world. We already discussed that the first nuclear power station was built in Britain in 1956 at Calder Hall. Thereafter, n number of nuclear stations has developed in United Kingdom. Presently, the nuclear power provides 14% of total energy output in UK. However, after this, the Britain was rapidly overtaken in this field by USA. The other countries with significant investment in nuclear power are China, Japan, Germany, Russia, Ukraine, France, Sweden, Canada and Spain. The most recent trend is the development of nuclear stations in developing countries that finds an alternative to the conventional forms of electricity production. Among these countries are Egypt, Brazil, Iran, Iraq, South Korea, India, Pakistan, Taiwan and Argentina. In 2018, the nuclear plant supplied 2,563 terawatt hour of energy against 2,503 terawatt hour in 2017. This is the sixth consecutive year that the global nuclear generation has risen, with output 217 terawatt hour higher than in 2012. North America and the European nations have high amount of nuclear energy production when compared to other continents. Let's look into the top producers of nuclear energy in the world. USA is the largest nuclear power producer in the world. The country produced 809.078 trillion terawatt energy in 2018. There are 95 operable nuclear reactors in the country with a combined net capacity of 96.8 gigawatts. In 2019, the nuclear power generated almost 20% of the country's electricity needs. France is the second largest nuclear power producer in the world. The country has produced 395.9 terawatt in 2018. There are 56 operable nuclear reactors with a combined net capacity of 61.4 gigawatt energy. In 2019, the nuclear generated almost 71% of the country's electricity needs. A 2015 energy policy has aimed to reduce the country's share of nuclear generation to 50% by 2025. However, this policy has been now extended its deadline to complete its 50% energy needs to 2035. China is the third largest power producer in the world. The country has produced almost 277.056 terawatts of nuclear energy in 2018. There are 47 operable nuclear reactors with a combined net capacity of 45.5 gigawatts. In 2019, the nuclear energy generated almost 5% of the country's electricity needs. The country continues to dominate in the market for new nuclear buildings. At the start of 2020, 11 of the 53 reactors under the construction globally were in China. Russia is the fourth largest nuclear power producer in the world. The country produced 191 terawatt energy in 2018. There are 38 operable nuclear reactors with a combined net capacity of 29.2 gigawatt energy. In 2019, the nuclear energy generation met almost 20% of the country's electricity needs. Now, Russia is trying to build its strength over the nuclear industry, which is highly reflected in its dominance of export market for new reactors. The country's national nuclear industry is currently involved in many new nuclear reactor projects, especially in Belarus, China, Hungary, India, Iran, and Turkey, and to varying degrees as an investor in many countries like Algeria, Bangladesh, Bolivia, Indonesia, Jordan, Kazakhstan, Nigeria, South Africa, Tajikistan, and Uzbekistan. Besides the above said countries, South Korea dominates in the fifth position in the generation of nuclear power. It is followed by Canada, Ukraine, Germany, Sweden, and United Kingdom in the top 10 position. Let's look into the present scenario of the nuclear power energy production in the world. As per the World Nuclear Association report, the nuclear energy currently provides 10% of the world's electricity from 440 power reactors. Nuclear energy is the world's second largest source of low carbon power in generating the energy, almost 29% of the total in 2017. Over 50 countries utilize nuclear energy in about 220 research reactors. In addition to these research, these reactors are used for the production of medical and industrial isotopes as well as for training purposes. I hope you have enjoyed today's session. For any doubts or clarifications or your queries, please post in your comment box or through the Edmodo. Thank you, and I wish you a great day ahead.